Bleeding Edge subscribers, hopefully you guys are doing well. Colin Tedder here. And look, 4 weeks ago, I came to you here on the newsletter with a message that the next 4 weeks would define the 2024 stock market. And that's exactly what's happened. Shares of NVIDIA, which have traded higher 13 out of the last 15 months, are now down 10% this month alone. It's not just NVIDIA. Shares of AMD are down 15%. And other hardware stocks in the broadly diversified semiconductor ETF, the SMH, are down about 10%. The losses haven't just been confined to the semiconductor industry either. Virtually everywhere you look, many stocks have rolled over since the start of the month. But we're about to head into the biggest week yet. When I identified the beginning of April and how critical this month would be, it was because of this week. On Wednesday, we'll hear from Meta. The social media giant still relies almost exclusively on advertising for revenue, but the company has been playing a critical role in the advancement of AI. Last week, Meta released Llama 3, an open source large language model. It follows the successful release of Llama 2, which was one of the most widely used large language models today. Elon Musk even weighed in on the release, calling the new LLM not bad on Twitter. The open source release means anyone can use the model for its own purposes, and it really kind of flies in the face of Google and Microsoft, which are spending tens of billions of dollars on large language models that are proprietary to them. Now, when Meta releases their earnings later this week, very little will rely on AI. It actually all comes down to online advertising spend, and that's what I'll be monitoring very closely. Weakness in online ad spend gives us really further evidence the consumer is stretched and small business is starting to pull back. Google will follow with earnings on Thursday. Again, it will all be about advertising in terms of revenue and profits. The first test for AI software earnings will begin on Thursday as well when Microsoft reports its earnings. The software giant is really well ahead of its peers, rolling out its Copilot AI feature late last year. Combined, these three companies have the ability to turn these markets on a dime. If Meta and Google show robust advertising spend, it's a sign that despite inflationary pressures and higher interest rates and other things, small businesses and consumers continue to remain resilient. Microsoft can send other software stocks like maybe Salesforce, ServiceNow, Adobe, others, flying if it can show investors that real profits are coming from AI. But look, there's actually a more important number that I'm focused on this week. In fact, I hope the number goes unnoticed by most investors so you and I can take advantage of this huge opportunity. In the short run, Google, Microsoft, Meta, they may disappoint investors, and the shares of these companies, which really have been on a tear for nearly a year and a half now, might fall even further. But one quarter isn't going to derail the largest investment in technology that you and I have ever seen. The real number to look for isn't what Microsoft and these companies are bringing in terms of revenue and profits. It's what these three companies are spending. Microsoft and Google have committed $50 billion each in data center spending just for the year of 2024. Meta is projecting just under $40 billion. Any indication of a slowdown in spending will signal the hardware cycle of AI has officially peaked. Shares of NVIDIA, AMD, and others will have likely seen their highs of the year. But that's not what I'm expecting. That's because these companies know exactly what's at stake. Google has to protect its $2 trillion search engine. Microsoft has to protect its $3 trillion software business. And Meta, look, it can't get left behind like pretty much every other social media website has seen before. In order to do this, these companies have to spend billions of dollars to create and launch new AI products and services in the coming months and years ahead. But here's the deal. Wall Street investors, they're going to want results this week. But the fact of the matter is, Microsoft is the only company that will print real revenue and profits from AI really out of anybody this quarter. Google and Meta and others can really only show how much they are spending and investing. With Wall Street already on edge, this can create a situation we really dream of as long-term investors, one where Wall Street is focused on one quarter or the short term, and one where we can focus on more. Look, great technology advancements, they're not a sprint. They are a marathon. And the AI race has only just begun. I'll be back later this week to dissect the results and really let you know what I think is happening next. Until then, have a great week, and I'll see you again soon.